हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मैं डॉक्टर शीतल कुलकर्णी एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज बायोमेडिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन यूनिट टू फिजियोलॉजिकल सिस्टम्स एंड रिलेटेड मेजरमेंट नर्वस सिस्टम। इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ईईजी, दैट इज फर्स्ट वन इज रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ इवोक पोटेंशियल, कंप्यूटराइज्ड एनालिसिस ऑफ ईईजी एप्लीकेशंस एंड रिसेंट अपडेट्स। Recording of evoke potential. If an external stimulus is applied to a sensory area of the brain, it responds by producing an electrical potential known as evoke potential. The most frequently used evoke potential for a clinical testing including brainstem, auditory evoke responses, visual evoke responses, and somatosensory evoke potentials. Evoke potentials recorded at the surface of the brain is the integrated response of the action of many cells. The amplitude of the evoke potential is of the order of 10 microvolts. The evoke potentials are generally superimposed with the electroencephalogram. Therefore, it is necessary to remove the EEG by an averaging technique while making evoke potential measurement. The background EEG and other unwanted signals often appear irregular and do not synchronize to stimuli. They are markedly reduced by averaging across the multiple trials. Most of the improvements in the signal to noise ratio occur within the 40 to 100 trials. Since many evoke potential components are of short duration, about 2 milliseconds to 1 second, rapid sampling rates are needed to digitally record such low level potentials. Usually, the sampling rate is 1000 per second. The amplitude of evoke potentials are normally measured on a vertical scale with sample points measured as bits on a logarithmic resolution scale. Resolution of voltage is usually sufficient with a 8-bit recording. Although 10 to 16-bit analog to digital systems are becoming available, recording of evoke potential, computerized analysis of EEG and applications. Computerized analysis of EEG. Modern machines make use of computerized EEG signal processing to extract and present the frequency and amplitude information in simple, visually enhanced formats that are directly useful to the clinicians. Frequency analysis. It takes the raw EEG waves, mathematically analyzes them and breaks them into their component frequencies. The most popular method of doing this is fast Fourier transform, FFT. Fast Fourier transformation of the digitized EEG waveform is a mathematical transformation of a complex waveform having varying frequency and amplitude into a simpler, more uniform waves. In this method, the EEG signal is converted into a simplified waveform called spectrum. It is then separated into a frequency band at intervals of 0.5 Hz over a range of 1 to 32 Hz. The redistribution of electrical activity in the brain among certain frequency bands or the predominance of one band over the other correlates with specific physiological and pathological conditions. The spectral analysis transforms the analog EEG signal recorded on the time axis into a signal displayed on the frequency axis. Amplitude analysis. Changes in the EEG amplitude can indicate clinical changes. The amplitude changes result in the changes in the power of resulting frequency spectrum. As the amplitude increases, so does the power. The most common number reflecting EEG amplitude is the total power of the EEG spectrum. Due to the microvolt amplitude of EEG, power is either in nanowatts or picowatts. The power spectrum is calculated by squaring the amplitudes of the individual frequency component. The power of the individual frequency bands are also commonly used as expressed as an absolute or percentage of total power. Complex spectral array. In this format, a series of computer smooth spectral arrays are stacked vertically, usually at 2 second intervals, with the most recent EEG event at the bottom and the oldest at the top. peaks appear at a frequency which contain more power or more make larger contributions to the total power spectrum. Since the origin of the plot shift vertically with the time, this produces a pseudo three-dimensional graph. With this method, it is easy to pick up changes in the frequency and amplitude of each sample over a longer period of time as it compresses a large amount of data into a compact, easy-to-read train. Hence, it is called as compressed spectral array, CSA, dot density modulated spectral array. It is another method for displaying power spectra. This format displays a power spectrum as a line of variable intensities or densities with successive epochs again stacked vertically in a CSA plots. Areas of greatest density represent frequencies which make the greatest contribution on the EEG power spectrum. DSA displays will be in the form of gray or colored scale densities. Use of EEG. Mostly the EEG used for detecting epilepsy, generalized grand mal seizures or absence petimal seizures. Next, it is used to localize brain tumors also. Next, it can be used for sleep disorders and sleep apnea syndrome, isomnia and parasomnia. Helpful in knowing the corpial activity, toxicity, hypoxia, encephalopathy and determination of brain death. Flat EEG, absence of electrical activity on two records run for 24 hours apart. Figure shows the alpha, beta, gamma rays of EEG. The MATLAB application for analysis of EEG. Next, it is the MATLAB application of analysis of brain tumor. MATLAB application of MEG and EEG and the special functions of brain and brain intensity can be detected using MATLAB. All these special features of EEG and applications are shown in this slide. Thank you, students.